knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Have you ever wondered why crime-related TV shows and movies like CSI, Sherlock, or Silence of the Lambs are so incredibly popular? This is because of the curiosity and appetite for suspense that we naturally possess. Everyone loves the shocking twist where the real killer is revealed. And we hate spoilers because it robs us of the opportunity to use our own reasoning to solve the case. Such shows have made us aware of the utility of science in solving a crime. But depicting all the procedures that take place in real life is not feasible. We are typically shown simplified versions of scientific procedures, which create unrealistic expectations regarding the investigation. There's so much to crime scene investigation beyond what you see on TV. In fact, there's a whole branch of science completely dedicated to CSI called forensic science. However, it is not a completely new branch of science. We often talk about physics being the fundamental science. We also refer to chemistry as the central science. Biology is the science central to life. So what about forensic science? The science that deals with the application of all these other natural sciences is forensic science. It could rightly be called a progeny of science. While natural sciences are theoretical, dependent on pure knowledge, forensic science is practical, applied to real-world problems, and subject to more conjecture and approximation. So forensic science demands observation and the application of logical reasoning. Let's understand what the word forensic means. This word is derived from the Latin word forensis, which means belonging to debate or discussion. It implies that investigation is never certain, and it is a result of reasoning and conjecture. FS is defined as the application of scientific methods and techniques to matters under investigation by a court of law. It's all about establishing a link between the victim, the suspect, and the crime scene. With recent advancements in technology, criminals have discovered novel ways to commit a crime and get away with it. Therefore, it is almost impossible to investigate such crimes without using science and technology. This is where FS has become an integral part of the criminal justice system. It helps in recognizing and gathering evidence from a crime scene for scientific analysis in the laboratory. This aids in determining the guilt or innocence of a suspect. Unlike natural scientists, it is fundamental for a forensic scientist to become familiar with the process of law. They are bound to use their scientific skills for the greater public good. This is why forensic science is also called a public science. The greatest duty of a forensic scientist is to subvert unrealistic expectations from society, which carries a glorified image of forensics generated through novels, movies, and television. As an expert witness in the courtroom, they must explain the evidence to the courtroom in a clear and succinct manner. They should avoid any scientific jargon so that everyone can understand what the evidence entails. They know that their testimony could make or break the case, and it could mean the difference between conviction and exoneration. So, although forensics is not a fundamental science, it is the only one directly influencing justice. In this series, we will try to cover all types of investigation related to forensic science. First, we will learn about the basics of crime, the principles of forensics, followed by certain basic procedures common for all investigations. Then we will move on to different kinds of evidence analyses related to different domains. These are impression evidence, which includes fingerprints, lip prints, footprints, footwear prints, and more. Forensic biology and serology, which involve the analysis of different biological fluids, such as blood, semen, vaginal fluid, sweat, saliva, and tears. Questioned document analysis, where we study handwriting, different types of papers and inks, counterfeit currency, and other counterfeit documents. Forensic physics, which involves different physical evidence, such as glass, paint, soil, fibers, and accident investigation. Forensic ballistics will involve investigation related to arms and ammunition. Forensic chemistry and toxicology involves analyzing different types of drugs, fuels, and fire investigation. Forensic medicine will include investigation after death. And forensic anthropology will involve the estimation of sex, stature, race, and age of a person from skeletonized remains. We will also be covering some interesting case studies related to each category of evidence. At times, we will see graphic and unsettling images wherever visual representation is necessary. Therefore, strict discretion is advised. This series will act as a supplement not only for forensic science students, but also for other science students who are curious about the application of their science in crime investigation and the justice system. It will also serve as entertainment for fans of Sherlock Holmes who are not academically invested, but are enticed enough by the stories to want to learn about this topic in detail. We will learn certain intricacies of investigating so as to be able to distinguish between an accident, a crime, and a natural death. So if all of this sounds fascinating to you, let's move forward and learn about forensic science.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.